It has erupted between veteran television producer Dick Clark and president of the National Academy of Recording Arts and Sciences.
Michael Green has said in print, and this is almost an exact quote, if you, as an artist, if you do the American Music Awards, you might as well buy a ticket to the Grammys. That's the only way you'll get on.
It was a tug of war over one performer that started the legal battle.
The straw that broke the camel's back was the Michael Jackson situation.
After Jackson agreed to perform on the American Music Awards, Dick Clark alleges that Michael Green pressured the singer to cancel his AMA appearance, an allegation Green denies. Don't expect Jackson to perform live on the American Music Awards. What viewers will see is a taped performance, but he will be there to accept his award.
First, I'd like to say, Chris Tucker, you are the funniest man in the world. I'd like to thank people that are very important in my life.
Dazzling wedding is our top Hollywood story.
And it was a showstopper. We have the exclusive footage of the newlyweds leaving the reception. And from Michael Jackson with Elizabeth Taylor to the roses inside the church, we have secrets from the ceremony first up tonight. Best man Michael arrived in the same limo with matron of honor Elizabeth and Diana Ross with her son. The four went in to greet Liza as she was getting dressed for the nuptials, which were witnessed by nearly 1,100 guests. David and Liza owe their wedded bliss to the King of Pop. David produced the CBS special saluting Michael Jackson's 30 years in show business, and Liza was a guest.
You are not alone.
There's a picture from OK magazine. Look at that, wow.
Oh, my God.
Now, the two in the middle look fine. But the other two, it's the Addams Family. Come on.
Johnny, what did you do? You've touched it up.
I haven't touched anything up.
Singer Michael Jackson concluded the DNC fundraiser. Last Wednesday's Night at the Apollo raised $2.5 million for the Democratic Party. The money is expected to be used for a nationwide voter registration drive.
Yes, guest of May appeared Lord Jammer, who fixed up the guided tours, a favor to his friend, the psychic Uri Geller.
Hey, everybody.
Thank you.
Pardon?
What are you waiting to see again?
Gee, I don't know. I haven't been in yet.
Tonight he was mobbed in Devon, where he was made an honorary director of Exeter City Football Club. Uri Geller is the chairman of Exeter.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Michael Jackson and Uri Geller to the pitch of Exeter City Football Club.
Says his record company is bad. They say he is off the wall. Michael Jackson has gone to war with Sony Entertainment. He accuses Sony of failing to promote his last album, Invincible. Jackson joined civil rights activist Al Sharpton in New York to protest alleged racism in the U.S. music industry. And he bitterly criticized Sony Entertainment chairman Tommy Mottola.
We must put an end to this racism. Racism is bad. Tommy Mottola made some very racist remarks.
Mottola retorted he had championed Mr. Jackson's career for many years, and Sony called Jackson's claims ludicrous.
feed the conspiracy. You have to know that. I know my race. I just look in the mirror. I know I'm black.
Sharpton was saying, people from James Brown to Sammy Davis Jr., some of the real pioneers that that inspired me to be the entertainer that I am. These artists are always on tour because if they stop touring, they would totally go broken.
The product of James Brown and some of these others at the end of their careers are broken, penniless.
Yeah.
What is your financial situation?
I'm in an incredible financial situation. I just wrote somebody a check for $500 million. But when good news doesn't sell, if it's something negative and that's a rumor, that's when it's blasted.
Is Michael Jackson's lavish lifestyle finally catching up to him?
He's still worth about $800 million, but much of that is debt. Much of it is in assets that are not liquid.
In just 1 month, Jackson spent $200,000 at an electronics store, $150,000 on travel, $40,000 on limousines, and $10,000 at a pharmacy.
Flying around the world with an entourage, hiring a voodoo witch doctors to consult with him.
Inspired me and just about everybody in this room and the world. I consider him the artist of the millennium. So happy birthday, my friend, the King of Pop.
When I was a little boy in Indiana, if someone had told me that one day I would be getting, as a musician, the Artist of the Millennium Award, I wouldn't have believed it. All the fans around the world, I love you. God bless you. Thank you.
Dear guest of honor, dear Mr. Gorbachev, it is a great honor for me to be selected by Mr. Gorbachev and the jury to receive the World Arts Award 2002.
Bizarre. We are looking at someone who's had extensive surgery to his nose, obviously surgery to his lower eyelids. His skin is considerably paler. His facial proportions are completely abnormal. And the overall effect is unnatural.
Singing in a band with his brothers, to a man who's changed the colour and features of his face and dangled his baby off a hotel balcony. Everyone's thinking, why did he do that? Think of, you know, he's caught in between trying to, you know, please his fans, here's my baby, and trying to protect his child.
Yeah, okay, I can understand all of that, but that his judgment is perhaps not the judgment of others, of the majority. The majority wouldn't dangle a child over a balcony for the hell of it with a towel over his face, wouldn't take the children out veiled to the zoo. This business about having two wives, three children, but they don't have no mother. And it is truly the Peter Pan lost boys syndrome. Is it ever going to be too late to, I'm thinking of the children,
sure,
to not perpetuate this generation of mistakes. Is it ever too late to help those children?
Pop artist of the millennium.
Congratulations.
Glückwunsch, du bist der Beste.
Remains the biggest selling album in the history of the world, period. That's why I'm thrilled to present this award to the King of Pop, Michael Jackson.
Thank you so much. I'm very honored. I'm very happy. I thank all the people that appreciate my work. I thank the Billboard Awards. I've always admired you. And to the fans around the world, I love you. I couldn't be me without you.